Good morning, everybody. How are you? Thank you for showing up. So basically, I am going to do a very short healing circle, prayer circle, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. And this is really just an opportunity to focus our attention on people and places and situations that we are noticing need some extra special TLC at the moment. And I don't know about you, but I've certainly got, you know, lots of friends and, you know, some family members, they're just in the trenches. And, you know, when you're in the trenches, you're in survival mode. And it's just really hard. It's really, really, really hard. And so it's at times like this that we need lots of extra comfort and care. And we can't always physically do that. And so this is an opportunity, especially during a lockdown, this is an opportunity to actually kind of shore up some of that and send it out to the world with some kindness and generosity. So thank you so much for dropping in and being part of this. So before we begin, I just want to acknowledge the Bundjalung, the Widjibal Ngaiyibal people, the Bundjalung Nation, on whose land we live and I work. And I would like to pay my respects to the elders past, present and emerging, and recognize that sovereignty was never ceded on this land. So let's begin. I'm just going to give you a little bit. I've never been a big prayer. Religion was not a big part of my life, but recently it's come into my life through the work of Saint Teresa of Avila. She's written many books, but the one, The Interior Castle. And I don't know what it is about Teresa, but she was quite a character and she was quite sparky. And I really love that about her, because she was really human, you know, and yeah, she was just quite an amazing teacher. And her work has been translated by, this book's by Mirabai Starr, and Caroline Mice has translated some of her work. But anyway, she and Caroline, whose book called Intimate Conversations with the Divine, which is currently stuck to my desk because I put a big wad of blute out there, because sometimes I like to have a little bit of a stress ball. But anyway, Caroline Mice's Intimate Conversations with the Divine, Prayer Guidance and Grace. And what I love about this is it's just really a very intimate look at Caroline's sort of prayer life and how she kind of, you know, will write and say, I don't understand why something is happening and it's so confusing and it's overwhelming. And so I hand this over to a higher power and I ask for the graces of, you know, and whatever she needs, it might be fortitude, it might be comfort, it might be mercy, it might be mindfulness, especially if it's, you know, there's something that's coming up in her that she doesn't like or she's wishing would go away. And I just find that in the back of this book, it's got this index of graces, which is just helps you kind of focus in on, you know, what you feel, you know, humanity might need. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of tune in and listen. If you're here and you're tuning into this, wherever you're watching this, and for people who are here, if you just bring a list of people and situations that are maybe you're struggling with, that you see the world is struggling with, what you see your countries maybe struggling with, if you bring all of that and we'll just bring it into our soup pot, really pop it all in there right now, okay? And just imagine that we are popping those in to planet Earth. So let's imagine that we are sort of outside planet Earth right now, and we're looking towards it, okay? And all of the people and all of the things that, you know, we're struggling with, or that we want to send love and compassion and kindness to, are in there, okay? And what I want us to do now is I want to bring in our kind of heart squad, as Amanda Ellis calls it, but our heart squad, but our compassion teachers and support people, okay? So those people might be, you know, a family member that has maybe passed over. So it might be somebody, you know, it might be a grandparent or a parent, or it might be your pet, you know, somebody that you had great love for. So it might be a childhood pet, it might be, you know, a childhood friend that you have, but something that starts to invoke this feeling of, oh, love, real love, beautiful, unconditional love. It might also be, I was thinking this morning, you know, of all the things that bring in, and it might just be, you know, as a child when you used to watch TV, I remember I used to just have this amazing, I'm not sure if it was a crush, but this amazing just sense of feeling so calm and happy when I was in the presence of Brian Cant, who was the presenter for Play School. Let me tell you, when I saw Brian Cant's face and he was so smiley and happy, I would just be like, oh, the world's great. So I'm bringing him in, and, you know, there may be a spiritual teacher or that you would like to bring in, or somebody who's inspired you, great leaders that have inspired you, bring them in. Okay, bring them all in. So really bring all these people into your energy field. So it fills up with all this sort of strength and fortitude and love and compassion for humanity, that you can see the struggles and you can see people that are maybe sick or overwhelmed or tired or stressed or exhausted, people that have no privilege, people that are in detention centers, people who are in hospitals, people who are alone and frightened. Really, you know, people who have got children that are not sleeping at night, you know, prisoners, people who are, you know, addicts, you know, all of the people, people that are trying to write a book and they can't think what the next chapter, the next word is. You know, in the grand scheme of things, you know, they differ widely, but for that person, it might just feel really overwhelming. So can we just see that pain and that suffering in that world in front of us? And can we just see that and feel that beautiful kind of shored up sense of love and compassion within our own energy field from all the people and things that we've brought in from our own life? And what I want you to do now is, as you imagine, just maybe shutting your eyes, just sort of, let's shut our eyes. So let's just grounding ourselves down, feet on the ground, imagining roots going down into the ground, okay? Just allowing that to get hold, so you're tethered tight, okay? And then opening up to wider set of consciousness, to the cosmic, you know, guidance of the world, to a higher power, and allowing that to come through now into our heart space. And then just imagining from our heart space all of what we've brought in to fill it. Allow, as we breathe in and as we breathe out, just imagine all that love now flowing in to planet Earth. And all those people who are on our list, all those situations who are on our list, receiving that, okay? And again, just breathing it in And as you breathe out, releasing all that love into the planet, into all those people who are struggling right now, feeling lost, feeling confused, feeling frightened, overwhelmed. And again, breathing it in, and then breathing all that love in, allowing it to travel wherever it is needed. Sending in grace of balance, of blessings, of clarity, of comfort, of compassion, of counsel, of courage, of determination, devotion, of discernment, and divine intervention, grace of endurance, epiphany, expectancy, faith, forgiveness for ourselves and for others, fortitude, generosity, gratitude, healing, hope, humility, joy, and listening, and love, so much love. And the grace of mercy. I know I used to call that in a lot when I was struggling with my own health. Found so much comfort just there, just calling that in. The grace of mindfulness, of nurturing, of protection, of providence, of quietude, resilience, silence, and strength, surrender, and trust, understanding, and wholeness, finding wholeness. Yeah. And then wisdom, and last of all, wonder, the grace of wonder. Can we still find that? Can we still find that? All that's going on. So just taking a moment to breathe all of those in and allow those to come through you again. And releasing them out into the world. All those graces, may they land wherever they need to. May they find the hearts and the minds and the souls of people who are struggling, who are confused, who are angry, who are frustrated and irritated. And may they support you now and support the world now. Thank you. Well, listen, thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate it. And I've recorded this so that I can pop this out into the world, and you can do it anytime you like. And it's just a way to kind of, you know, if you're feeling, then you've got this. Let it center you, let it, you know, fill yourself up, and then release it out into the world. And just allow the world to absorb what it needs from that experience, so that, yeah, we can find more balance and we can find more freedom, because I know so many of us are quite restricted at the moment. Anyway, thank you again for joining me, sending you so much love. And see you all again very soon. Thank you.